Wildcat for the first time. I don't know if it was my freshman year or if it was last year, but I remember I was like walking with people and I'm like very skittish and I saw something and I like jumped. And then I was like, oh my God, that's a cat. And I was so excited because I love cats so much. And I was just like, this is the best.
She came up to my house, this is actually before she was elected senator, and she was just hungry, looking for some food. So I let her in and she discussed that she was really interested in being elected to the position. So we chatted a bit about it from the CA perspective and what I'd need from a senator. And that was my first meeting with her.
And then I like was so excited, and then I told someone else about it, and they were like, oh yeah, that's Modcat. And they were like not excited at all, but I didn't live in the mods, so I like didn't realize that there was a cat in the mods.
I was moving in, carrying my my duffel bag, and she ran by me, and I threw my bags on the ground and ran into my mod.
That's the kind of cat Modcat was. Just walk right in, I'm part of your life, we're gonna have a great time, and even if you don't realize that now, you're gonna realize that soon.
We saw Modcat outside, and she walked into our suite. She walked right down into the kitchen, and she was rubbing up against one of my suite mates. The next thing we knew, she rolled over, belly was out in the air, and she just kind of stretched her paws out, and we were like, this is adorable.
Her name was Mimi Siku, means cat pee.
I've been through the mods a few times, in search of parties and alcohol. And at that point in time, I think I may or may not have met Modcat.
Yeah, there's a movie, a Disney movie with Tim Allen, where he meets his son, Mimi Siku, and he asks his son why he named himself that, because in that tribe they were allowed to name themselves, and he said it meant cat pee.
Kind of a joke, wasn't it?
To be honest, I saw it on Facebook first, which is funny because, you know, I live with Ian, so I'd expect to have heard about it. I saw it on Facebook and I was like, oh my God, this is hilarious. But then I think a lot of people really got behind it, and like, you know, Modcat was always there for us as people, and like, even if she had no idea what we actually needed, was like helpful and like would show people love and affection, right? So that's a nice thing to have.
Probably around midnight, I had come up with the idea of writing in Modcat. And so I had begun posting all over Facebook and the mods page, trying to get Modcat as the write-in senator.
Modcat stood for the people, whereas everybody else stands for popularity and for making things fun, whereas Modcat was purely doing it because he was a people person.
What was great about Modcat's campaign is that it was really just about flash and style, and I think that's what got so many people excited, was the utter lack of content or platform, and just really a focus on personality.
First, I think it was making sure that classes were open to not only humans, but also animals in general. Taking away the foreign language requirement, and also the math requirement.
She was really vested in what we had to say and what we had to offer, and if she could take a shortcut from the back of our house through the front of our house.
It was just it was so cool that many people thought that it would be a fun thing to do to write in Modcat. And then the fact that like we actually got an email that was like, Modcat won senator.
We threw a party. Modcat did not show up. However, one of Modcat's representatives ended up coming to the party, got a little too drunk, and we had to have a traditional post-rigor mortis funeral.
There was one day and it was cold and rainy and really, really terrible outside, and Modcat was outside of my sliding glass door, and she came inside and we tried to dry her off, but she didn't want to be dried off. Eventually we put the towel down and she curled up on it and fell asleep until I had to go to class. So I felt bad putting her back in the rain, and so then I tried to put her in my room and I was gonna like lock her in there with food and water. But then I realized that's probably a really bad idea because she needs to visit with other people as well. And so we had to kick her outside, and that was one of the last times I saw Modcat. So maybe if I hadn't kicked her out, things would be different.
The death of Modcat, probably, definitely, the biggest tragedy we have seen on this campus in a while.
I was here actually at the Gets Media Lab, and I just saw a post on the ModCat Facebook page and was just devastated. I think I messaged my mod and just, you know, just shared with them the sad news, and we all mourned for a few minutes.
I was on my way to class and I got a text message from a friend, Danny Steinberg, who said that he was driving and he saw the carcass of a cat on the side of the road and asked if I could go check it out. I ran down the stairs by the health center and I walked up and down the street trying to find the body of the cat to identify her. I talked to some people walking by asking if they'd seen a dead cat on the side of the road, which is a really good conversation starter.
It was as if like it was a student or like a family member. It was devastating, and actually I am not ashamed to admit this, I like went home later and actually did cry.
Somebody posted in the MUD 2014-2015 group saying that there was some unfortunate news and that the owner was very upset. And I didn't know necessarily what that meant. I thought it had something to do with just winning the senator position, and that it was, you know, she was gonna be very busy with meetings and such.
We had an opportunity to have a really interesting element of diversity in our student leadership that unfortunately with ModCat's passing becomes not possible.
I think it's hard to hit a cat with your car. Like, I've been driving for like several years. I've never hit an animal. I feel like usually you can see them. So it's all very suspicious.
Hit by a car. Am I saying it was assassination?
There have been a lot of turkeys around the mods in the last few weeks, and they didn't show up until the week that ModCat was assassinated. So I have a very strong theory that the turkeys were involved in the death of ModCat and have personally been offended when new elections roll around and people are like, oh, let's vote for like Mod Turkey. We don't know who her killer was.
Part of me does think that it was an assassination, you know, but, you know, ModCat was known to be careless. I think all his power went to his head. You know, he easily could have just not pressed the button.
But I wouldn't be surprised if like there was someone on this campus who was like, oh man, that's that cat. Like, fuck that cat, like, and just like thought it would be cool to hit a cat. Like, I'm not saying that we have like a campus of sociopaths, but in a campus like this size, statistically, there's at least a couple people who are probably sociopaths, and maybe they hit the cat. Also, I think Andrew Flagel was involved.
Well, I think anytime you get a politician that gets incredibly popular, there's going to be conspiracy theories that abound around both how a politician gets that popular and then their demise. And certainly we like to build up our heroes and then see them fall. And I think, is it possible that ModCat was victim to that? It seems unlikely that one could keep a conspiracy theory of that scope on a campus this close. But then again, ModCat was awfully popular and went far too soon.
It's definitely Andrew Flagel.
I think he would have hired a hitman who did the deed for him.
There's one ModCat. She's the one representative of the mods. And if we don't know who assassinated her, how can we accept any other animal?
Who knows, it could have been a gender thing. ModCat was a female cat. Maybe Brandeis just wasn't ready for it.
But I hadn't thought about Sodexo or Xerox. I mean, I'd be concerned that the assassinator, whoever that may be, could pin it on them, so careful what you hear.
If anyone was to have assassinated ModCat, it's Sodexo. Let's just say it.
You know, ModCat was always there for people, just to be someone you could pet and show affection to, and you know, she really didn't care, which was, I think that's the legacy that ModCat left behind, which is just kind of this, there's always somebody who was around who was affectionate.
I think ModCat sort of inspired, you know, other animals to get into the game, to take up, you know, ModCat's mantle in the student union, just sort of inspired, you know, all sort of woodland creatures to get involved, you know, Mod Deer, Mod Possum, you know, and of course Mod Raccoon, the most popular of the group.
If Modcat can do it, so can we. So, it's an inspiration for us all to just get our acts together.
The legacy of Modcat is really something that Modcat takes to the grave. We won't know that until we really see how history judges Modcat.
He was a constant. When a lot of different things change, when a lot of people change, when the entire mods are remodeled, and the entire familiar environment becomes unfamiliar, the one thing that remains there and stoic is Modcat.
What makes them good stories is the fact that they were just completely random. That, you know, you weren't expecting to hang out with Modcat. You had no idea how long she was going to stay for. You had no idea what she was going to do. But you just kind of treasured the couple of moments that you had, right? So what for other people might seem like insignificant memories, you know, Modcat comes and sits on a chair. For the people who cared about her, they were special, right?